So we're going to be talking about compliance today with OpenSCAP, right? And Josh has a decent background in security and compliance and whatnot, so we thought we'd bring him in for the show. So Josh, do you want to hop into our critical path demo here? We're going to talk about kind of scanning for compliance and, you know, what OpenSCAP tools are available to us. And then in the deeper dive, we're going to talk a little bit more about why.
Right. So just to lay down some groundwork, that OpenSCAP is the tool we're using for security automation that can be used to check and enforce security configurations. To get started with this, let's just jump on in. First, we're going to install OpenSCAP. And this is simple enough. We can just go sudo yum install OpenSCAP-scanner. We're doing TACY for yes for automatic install, for saying, yes, I want to install these packages. Next, we're going to go through and install the SCAP security guide. And that's a install TAC security TAC guide. Once that's installed, we should be good to go. I'm realizing that I might have grabbed the same terminal that we've already been working with, which is awesome. Let's go paste. This is the way to be able to verify that things have been downloaded in the right order. See underneath user share XML SCAP SSG. We'll go over more of this later. But the long story short is we see this RHEL 9 is installed. So to get ourselves up and running, let's find out what OpenSCAP goes through and the commands that we need to go through and do. So we can just simply go oscap. And we've got our usages, our different commands. So we're going to go oscap, put our commands in, module and operation. So as an example, we're going to do this guy, which is OpenSCAP info. We're finding out information about the SSG for RHEL 9. There are a lot of different frameworks that you can go through and harden your system to. So we've got STIGs, we've got the CIS benchmarks. So that's what we have here. We can see there's benchmark for level 2 server, benchmark for level 1 server, level 1 workstation, and level 2 workstation. We'll go more into the details or the differences between there. Let's go ahead and get this thing kicked off. We're going to start off with the super basic just for the demo purposes for now. We're going to go with the CIS server 1. Let me clear the screen again here and let's paste this. So we're going sudo oscap. We're running a couple of the different commands here to be able to evaluate our system. The profile is going to be for the CIS server level 1 for RHEL 9. So let's go ahead and hit enter. This is going to take a minute or so for it to run. Not too long because it's just a, hey, here's the snapshot of what your system currently looks like. Nate, you have anything to add?
So this is actually going out and checking the configuration on the system, comparing it to the configurations defined within the SCAP security guide. So this will actually give you pass-fail on all the different rule sets and whatnot that are in there. So pretty handy tool.
Absolutely.
Great, right? For baselining, right?
Absolutely. That's the important point is if you're a sysadmin coming blind or you just inherited systems that you have no idea where the compliance level is, this is a great place to find out where your starting point is before you start changing anything. So this will only take another minute or so. The cool thing is that It comes up with the title, the rule, and the identifier, which if you're in compliance or you need to be able to say that you're compliant with a certain ID, this one says the CCE and then the number. It's a great way to be able to cross-reference. So it's done running pretty quick. Let's go ahead and make a report and let's make sure we get the copy.
Yeah, so it's great that it outputs to the screen, but you can actually have it generate a report file. Which Absolutely. You can then save and view offline, which is handy.
Compared to your other machines, maybe that's on your network or the before and after of when you harden, right? So in this case, we're going sudo oscap. We're going to generate report. And then we're telling the output is going to be opensCAP_report-file. And let's go ahead and hit enter on this. This won't take long. Yes, we can clear the screen to be able to see the full command here. Let me cancel this, go clear. And I'll do that every time from here moving forward. As we go through and generate the report, TAC output, it's going to do it to this. It's not going to take that long because it's converting it from an XML over to an HTML file, because you can do this in either just a report that you can look on the command line, or you can also do it as HTML. We're just going to go through and look through it through an old school terminal browser called lynx. This gives us the ability to look at web pages just in our console.
Yep. So Lynx is a text mode web browser. If anybody's not familiar, you can view this in a full browser as well. But to be honest, the output isn't much better. It's a pretty right? simple, it's a pretty simple thing, but it's maybe easier to read if you have it in a browser.
Right. As an example, if you had this on a server versus a GUI system, you could still look at this if you didn't SCP it over to your box or such. So if we scroll down, we can actually see the scoring system. I did this on the same box after hardening. So that's awesome. We can go through and talk about that a little bit more, because apparently when I opened a second tab, my demo system is already hardened. We can go through and see from the scoring system percentage-wise how hardened this box is. By default, this is much lower before you go through and harden things. And if we go through and quit, I think we're ready to go into the next section.
All right.